Ever look in your makeup bag like I do and wonder what brush is supposed to be used for what? I still do this after getting my makeup done daily. I still don't know. So we want to talk about which brush you use for which application.
Right. So here,
starting with your foundation.
Here's the brushes that you need.
All of them?
Yeah. So this this is what I use every morning to get this natural look that I have.
Oh my gosh, it's so pretty. Yeah. I love it.
Yeah.
See?
This
very
looks
nice.
Effortless. No. So, you know, as a professional.
Yeah, you would want all of
this. Yeah, we've got tons of brushes. So brushes are an investment. And I want to point out that I have, this is just one I pulled out of my kit. That was funny. Someone's having a good time.
I know, I like that.
I just happened to pull this out, but this brush is one of a set of brushes that I bought 25 years ago when I studied makeup.
You're kidding
And I went, so the point I'm making is if you take care of your brushes, they are an investment. Mm-hmm. 25 years later, like I still have those brushes and I've added to them.
We want to talk about what makes a brush more expensive and the sort of brush you should buy as well.
So really it's not about expense, it's about quality.
Okay.
There's some brushes where, you know, I see they're like, you know, those really cheap ones that are at Christmas time.
Yeah,
you pull on the hair and it comes out. Not a good quality brush,
right.
Okay? So you should be able to pull on them and they're not going to come out.
Right.
I will say that when brushes are manufactured, you may have before you use it the first time, some little hairs in there from how they're trimmed.
Yeah.
So give it a wash first.
Okay.
And that's normal that some of the hairs come out before you use it.
Okay.
So do that.
Good.
So what are the sort of essentials? You don't need all of this.
Right.
I've gone through sort of a, you know, an average sort of makeup kit, and you can add to them. So first up, and I'm doing this in order of application.
Okay.
So first up, foundation brush.
Mm-hmm.
So I like using a foundation brush with foundation because it gives an airbrushed result. In this case, the first three brushes I'm showing you are our CoverFX brushes because we specialize in foundation.
Right.
And what's cool is this typically you get in a natural hair, goat mm-hmm. hair or an animal hair. The hairs are cut from the animals, they're shaved,
okay.
sort of like how we harvest wool. But the challenge with that is, especially in a cream foundation brush, it can break over time. This is actually synthetic, but it mimics a natural hair. And feel how soft that is.
Feels amazing.
Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
So soft. So what this does, it gives an airbrush look to the foundation.
Okay.
Okay. Now then we have a concealer brush. And what's important for a concealer brush is it's flat.
Right.
And this is synthetic. And what this does is when you're applying it, it actually lays down more coverage
mm-hmm.
because you're using this in spot areas, underneath the eyes, on blemishes, etc. So
right.
you want it to deposit more product.
Okay. That's why the hairs are so close together.
That's
right. You want it like that.
Then we have a powder brush, which will set, you know, like a loose powder or pressed powder or even powder foundation.
Uh-huh.
And this is sort of a larger brush because you're covering a larger area.
Mm-hmm.
And so again, this is, it looks like a natural animal hair, but it's actually synthetic.
So do you want synthetic then
over
natural?
The benefit is that it won't break.
Right.
Okay. Typically, you want animal hair for powder products because it makes it softer, but they've now engineered synthetic bristles to mimic animal hair.
Okay.
So you get a softer application, but without breakage.
Very
That's
good.
The benefit, okay?
I use that brush for everything.
Yeah, and so here's the
Not
thing
supposed
though.
To.
Okay, the difference is between a powder brush and a blush brush
mm-hmm.
is the size.
Yeah.
If you look at the size of the blush brush,
One's
it's smaller because, if we go to your face, where you want your blush is a smaller application.
Mm-hmm.
If I use a big brush, it's gonna give you more blush.
You look crazy, that's what I do.
Yeah, so thank God you've got
Tracy
Pierce who does your makeup.
Thank goodness.
Okay. Then for eyeshadow, sort of two brushes to start, and I'll sort of start with two eyeshadows, a light one and a dark one, and I've done these reversed.
Okay.
Let's say that you do a wash of color on, here, I'll do it this way. You can do it either way. A wash of color on your entire eyelid with a light color, with a wider brush that covers the whole eyelid.
Mm-hmm.
And in this case, I have to do a shout out to, hello, Dino Delio.
Oh, Dino Delio,
Thank you, Dino Delio. So my friend Dino has given me some of his brushes, and this, actually, I really love this brush for an eyeshadow.
Yeah.
Gives a soft wash. And then a crease brush, if you look at this, it's defined,
mm-hmm.
and it defines the crease. So that's how we get that color in the crease to define that area, but soft, because if you look at how this is tapered, it works beautifully, sorry, there you go, inside the crease area.
Okay, so you can use it either right at the tip or at the side.
Exactly,
if you're blending
and the trick
a little bit.
Is, I'm just gonna show in your eye, mm-hmm. is just like a windshield washer movement like this,
mm-hmm.
and what this does, there we go, the camera can see, is you end up creating that depth in the crease.
Right, okay? Which is what you're looking for. You want that shadowy
effect. And then finally is an angled brush. Yeah. And I love an angled brush for, I actually don't use pencil eyeliners that much. Okay. I prefer powder. And I just use eyeshadow.
Oh.
So, and use an angled brush with it, and also use this for your
eyebrows
as well.
Right.
Okay, that's what that's for.
That's really good. So the moms in the audience are like, okay, so I just need the concealer.
Could be, and that might be where you start. If you have dark circles, that might be where you start.
But that is good. That's a good, that's sort of a complete kit for those of us out there that just want a little bit of makeup.